Hey guys, it's Sarah from Just My Typewriter, and I love interesting functionality on typewriters. I've talked about this before. There's some just really interesting design elements that make using a typewriter more fun, more intriguing, and just more fashionable than using other typewriters. Each one has its own unique personality and style, and they all do similar things in different ways. I've talked about this before on a couple of my other typewriters. I love when you push a button and it opens the lid. One thing I've really been interested in is that on my Smith Corona pacemaker from the late 50s, early 60s, you can actually lift up one side of the platen, and it just makes it easier to get thicker papers in there, and there's a nice little lever on the front that lets you lift up that one side. I thought that you could only lift up one side of that typewriter's platen, until I met this typewriter at an estate sale, brought it home, realized you could remove the entire platen really easily, and then decided to go back and experiment with my pacemaker, and found out you can remove the entire platen. So I decided to do a little bit of research on both my Smith Corona pacemaker from the 1950s-60s and this new machine to my collection, which again I picked up at an estate sale for about 15 bucks. This is a 1962 Smith Corona Sterling. What I really liked about these machines was that they're both kind of a greenish color. They both have that nice 1950s style with the rounded edges, and they both have that interesting functionality. So let's talk a little bit about both of these machines. So my Smith Corona pacemaker is from like 1959, 1961-ish. I got it for about $25 at my favorite antique mall. I brought it home and I loved having it in my collection because it's this bright green color. But I had trouble doing extra research on this machine. There's not a lot of examples of it in the typewriter database. I had trouble finding advertisements that talked about the pacemaker. So this time I went through and did a little bit more digging. There are other examples of pacemakers on the typewriter database, and I entered mine into the typewriter database as well, but they're all in this desert sand color, and mine is this really bright green, which I found from a 1961 ad is called Spruce Green, which I think is the perfect name for it. This machine does look like some other models in the Smith Corona line, including the Secretary, and I also think it looks like some of the 1950s electric office machines. But when I did a little bit more digging, I found some actual advertisements specifically for the Smith Corona pacemaker. For example, I found this 1961 ad that lists the original price of this machine at about $200.87. Now, this was considered lower end for office big desk typewriters, and I think that's kind of interesting because to me, this machine seems to have all the bells and whistles, but when you look at some of the Smith Corona typewriters, they have a really vast price range, and they put different functions on different machines that might look the same so they can sell them at a cheaper cost. So this pacemaker, for example, was considered a lower end model, even though it looks similar to some of their higher end office models. What I also found was interesting was that I found a 1962 advertisement that talked about how the platen on this machine was interchangeable, which again, I had no idea I could do on this machine until I started messing around with it. I think that's a really cool feature because now you can change out the platen, you can get a resurfaced one pretty easily and just set it back down in there. They have Smith Corona dealer magazines that talk about you can order new platens for the machine and just interchange it pretty quickly. If you get something stuck in there or need to clean it out, so easy to remove that and clean it out underneath the platen area. But again, I didn't know this, and I had that machine for 3 years before I even figured that out. Now, this machine is a 1962 Smith Corona Sterling. I actually found this at an estate sale along with another Royal Futura typewriter, and I did a quick video on both these machines, how I purchased them for about 15 bucks each and redid them, cleaned them up a little bit. Thankfully, this machine wasn't too bad. It just had a little bit of oil and grease on the platen. I went to clean out that part of the platen, and I realized you could take the entire thing out. It's really simple. All you have to do is lift up this lever on the one side, unclick this button on the other platen knob, and the whole thing comes out. It's kind of like having a saber or a sword coming out of the machine. Really cool. And you could also interchange these as well. The most exciting thing just happened. So I need to clean under this platen, and I thought I was gonna have to take it out, and I wasn't quite sure how to do that. It's not like a typical Royal platen I've taken apart before. And then I realized this little doohickey with the spring on it, I didn't know what it did, so then I started hitting it as one normally does, and watch what happens. If I hit it, it releases the platen, so I can clean underneath of it. And that's where the oil got in from somebody trying to clean it before. So now I can clean underneath it and I don't have to remove the whole platen. This was a very exciting discovery. Thank you for joining us on the Discovery Channel with Sarah.
Oh my God, and then this happened. I just pulled this little lever out here and the whole thing came out. Man, this is cool.
Now the Stirling model was one of those like 1950s 5 series Smith Corona typewriters that are very popular, but it actually started out in about the 1930s with a flat top design. And like a lot of the other portable machines made by other typewriter companies, the name stayed the same, but the body design changed over time and is similar to a lot of other body designs in the Smith Corona line. So for example, in the 1930s, they have the flat top. When you get to the 1950s, that has this more rounded design. They have the nice little racing stripes down the front, and it's very similar to the Clipper or the Super Silent, that body design from the 1950s. When you get into the 1970s, a lot of the examples of Stirlings look similar to a Galaxy model or my Smith Corona Classic 12. Now, when you're looking at advertisements for this machine from the 1960s, they describe it in a couple different ways. But what they really tend to emphasize is that this is the mid-range model. So you can have a machine that's a little bit lower than this, that would be the Clipper. And then this machine is just one step up for the Clipper, both in price and in some of the functionalities. So they have the Clipper, then it's the Stirling, and then it's something like the Silent, which is considered the higher end version of that 5 series from the 1950s and 60s, both in price and in usage. Now this machine, I found an advertisement that described the finishes of these machines. You could get them in other colors such as coral pink and alpine blue. This one is described as sage gray, but it looks a little green to me. But when you compare it color-wise to my Smith Corona pacemaker, the pacemaker is much greener than this machine. But the beautiful finish on this is called sage gray, and it still has the nice cream keys, the same as the Smith Corona pacemaker. In 1962, which is the year that this machine is specifically from, it's listed for about $104, which again is that mid-range. The Clipper would be a little bit cheaper than that, and then this would have just a few extra things on top of that, including some extra like paper baler functions and some extra rollers on the front. And then above this price-wise would be something like the Silent or the Super Silent. Now, as I was sifting through different magazine ads and dealer ads for both the pacemaker and the Smith Corona Stirling, I found something really interesting, which is that the keys are called piano action keys. And in older advertisements, some of the lower end models are described as having piano action keys. In the advertisements from the 1950s that talk about how the Stirling is a step up from the Clipper, I actually found that the Clipper was described as having piano action keys. And then I found this ad from the 1960s talking about the pacemaker having this piano action key. And I didn't really know what that meant until I found this dealer pamphlet that talks about piano action keys being the Smith Corona specific design. And the idea is that when you depress a key on the actual keyboard, it stays parallel to the ground and it doesn't really lean as you're pressing down. So when you press down on the key, it goes straight down instead of shifting the key a little bit. Now to me, I thought that all typewriters did that, but Smith Corona specifically advertises that with their key design. And it is like when you're on a piano, when you press a piano key, it goes down straight instead of bending a little bit as you go down or tilting forward. And I think that might be just the way they describe their keys and their differentiator in the market. You'll see the Underwood talks about the golden touch, which we've talked about on this channel before, is just a specific way they formed the key tops for their machines. So piano action, I guess, is just Smith Corona's differentiator. So that's a little bit about these two machines in my collection. Now, again, what's really cool to me is how easy it is to take out the platen on both of these machines. I've taken apart a lot of 1950s Royals, and beyond just not loving 1950 Royal portable machines, the platen itself has a lot of screws you have to remove. So you have to remove screws on both platen knobs on both sides, and then on the inside you also have to remove or loosen a screw near the edges of the platen to release a rod in the middle. On both the pacemaker and on the Smith Corona Stirling, it's just a bunch of levers you have to press, and you can actually lift out the whole platen as a unit, so you don't have to remove any knobs, there's no extra rod you have to take out. On the Smith Corona Stirling, you lift up a lever on one side, take out the button on the other and you remove the entire platen with one platen knob on it. On the pacemaker, you actually lift up a lever on the right side and the left side and you can lift the entire platen, both knobs included, out of the machine. Now, I think this is a really cool function to have in both of these machines. I've never seen another machine like that, but I have a very limited collection. And I do think that's something really cool that differentiates these Smith Corona machines from any of the other machines in my collection. In addition, I just really like both of these typewriters. I think their colors are interesting. A lot of colored machines go for much higher prices, especially things that are pink and blue. And I have a lot of blue typewriters, but there's something that really stands out about this cool green finish, the spruce green on the Smith Corona pacemaker and the sage green on this Starling. So that's a little bit about these two machines in my collection. I really like their functionality. Even though they're lower end, I think they both type really well. Whether that's the piano action keys doing their job or just the fact that they're really nice machines, I don't know. But it's been really interesting to play with them, find out the cool design functionalities of these machines, and compare them to other typewriters in my collection. So if you're interested in other typewriter content about Smith Coronas, Royals, I have a lot of Royal typewriters, or anything else, I have some other videos on this YouTube channel which you can check out. You can also check out my Instagram at just.my.typewriter. I want to hear about some of the cool functions of your typewriters or your favorite design elements, so let me know in the comments below. I want to thank you so much for watching today, and remind you, you're just my type writer.